हेलो एवरीवन, आणि नमस्कार. दिस इज डॉक्टर सुदर्शन संभाजीराव बेळगे, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ झूलॉजी, जलसशरीराचे काम आदिले देवणे. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हॅव स्टडी द अबायोटिक फॅक्टर और अबायोटिक कंपोनंट्स, दॅट इज लाईट. ओके, इन दिस लेक्चर टुडे वी हॅव सीन it is the next abiotic component is temperature. So let's get started. Second abiotic component, temperature. Temperature is a physico-chemical, ecological abiotic factor. It is defined as the intensity aspect of heat. Okay. Temperature is a physico-chemical, ecological, abiotic factor, and it is defined as the intensity aspect of heat. Okay, it is a form of energy and is called thermal energy. It is a form of energy and is called thermal energy. Okay, another, it penetrates into every region of biosphere. Okay, it affects all forms of life. It influences the various stages of life activities such as growth, metabolism, reproduction, movement, distribution, behavior, death, etc. Okay, so temperature measure with the help of one unit. That unit is called Fahrenheit and centigrade. Okay, another next one is the, what is the sources of temperature? Okay, temperature at the earth's surface depends on the brightness of the sun. Okay, it means it's totally depends on the sun. The biosphere obtains its thermal energy mainly from the sun in the form of solar radiation. Okay, the heat is emitted by the visible light. We call it as in the last lecture we call it as vigor, right? And the infrared rays of the electromagnetic spectrum. So the temperature at the earth's surface depends on the brightness of the sun. Okay, next is the ranges of temperature. Okay, temperature is a variable factor. Temperature is a variable factor. It means we know very well, in the daytime temperature is different, in the night time temperature is different. Okay, in the daytime we have observed higher temperature. Okay, to compare the night time. Okay, at the night time it is a very lower temperature is there. That is the variability is there. Okay, it means that is the temperature is the variable factor. Okay, and that variableness in a day and night, that is called diurnal variation. We know very well, in the sea level of temperature is higher than that of high altitudes. Okay, if we check the temperature of sea level, okay, so you have find out that in that sea level, that is the, it will be increases in the temperature. And in the high altitudes, it means the northern region, if you go in the northern region, it is the Himalayan region, it is the high altitudes. Okay, that temperature, it will be the very low. It means the sea level and high altitudes, it affects, it is high at the sea level and the low at high altitudes. okay, it is high at the equator and low in the polar region. Okay, we know very well, equator means the earth is a very high temperature, as well as polar region, latitude and altitudes. Okay, it will be the very latitudes in, layer, it will be the higher temperature recorded, and altitudes is the very low temperature is there. Okay, that is the another, that is the terrestrial habitat and aquatic habitat. It's the best example of ranges of temperature, and we also seen the terrestrial habitat means a land habitat, or in the land temperature is the higher as compared to aquatic habitat. It means it is a lake or river. Okay, that is the temperature is totally different. The terrestrial habitat is higher and aquatic habitat is the lower temperature, we have seen. Okay, another, it is the open land and shady places. So we know very well, in the open land, it's a very scorching sun is there. Okay, it means it is a very higher temperature is there. Okay, but in we go into the shady places, okay, that time we feel one lower temperature is there. Okay, that is the ranges of temperature. Okay, and temperature is a variable factor. Okay, another, next is the biological effect of temperature. Okay, what is the biological effect of temperature? Okay, first is the tolerance to temperature. Okay, each and every organism has a particular range of temperature. We know very well, we have seen in the at the time of summer season, okay, as compared to the winter season, summer season is a very hot condition. It means that the temperature is, it is a very higher. Okay, and in the winter it is a very low. It means the each and every organism has a particular range of temperature at which the organism survives well. Okay, it means if it is not organism, if it is not present in a particular temperature, that time that temperature, it will be affects on that organism. Okay, and another, that is the death, it will be formed. Okay, that is the one particular reason for the temperature. Okay, it means the survival of organism, it is the most important factor is the temperature. It means the particular range of temperature is important. Okay, this temperature is called as optimum temperature. We call it as, that is the, that temperature is called optimum temperature. Okay, at the optimum temperature, the physiological activities are high, and hence the organism survive better. In means it is the optimum temperature, the physiological activities are high, and the organism survive better. The lowest temperature at which an organism can live indefinitely in an active state is called as minimum effective temperature. Okay, so this is the tolerance to temperature. Okay, next is the eurothermal organism. Okay, eurothermal organism. Okay, what is meant by the eurothermal organism? The organism which can tolerate wide ranges of temperature fluctuations are called eurothermal organism means those animals is easily tolerate wide ranges of temperature fluctuation. Okay, wide ranges of temperature fluctuation, that animal is called eurythermal animals or organism. Okay, they have adapt to adjust themselves to the fluctuation in temperature. Okay, we know very well, for example, man, lizards and amphibians, these animals can easily adapt in any temperature. Okay, it means they have easily adaptable nature in the body, they have easily survive in a fluctuation of temperature. If it is a higher temperature, that time those animals will be survive. If it is a lower temperature, that time those animals it also survive. Okay, it means the eurythermal organism is the wide ranges of temperature fluctuation tolerant. Okay, they okay, another next is the stenothermal organism. Stenothermal organism. Okay, the stenothermal organism, organism which cannot tolerate wide ranges of temperature fluctuation, are called stenothermal organism. Okay, if you compare eurythermal and stenothermal, in the eurythermal tolerate wide ranges of temperature fluctuation, and in stenothermal wide ranges of temperature tolerate wide ranges of temperature fluctuation sorry cannot tolerate wide ranges of temperature fluctuation, that animals is called stenothermal organism. Okay, on for example, that is the corals, snails, etc. We know very well coral snails. Okay, in the Marathi gogalgays. Okay, snails, we have seen that snails generally avoid higher temperature. It means that is the wide ranges of temperature, and not survive in the lower temperature also. Okay, they have survive only in the moderate temperature. Okay, that is the cannot tolerate wide ranges of temperature fluctuation, that animals is called stenothermal organism. Okay, another poikilothermic animals. Okay, poikilothermic animals means the body temperature changes according to the fluctuation of environmental temperature. These are called poikilothermic animals. Okay, what is mean by the poikilothermic animals? The body temperature changes according to the fluctuation of environmental temperature. These animals are called poikilothermic animals. Okay, in that, when the environment is cold, their blood also becomes cold, hence they are also called cold blooded animal. Okay, they cannot regulate their body temperature by metabolism, but they gain temperature from the environment, hence they are also called ectothermic animals. Okay, for examples, that is the birds and mammals. Okay, another next is the homeothermic animals. Example, except birds and mammals. Okay, poikilothermic means the cold-blooded animals. Okay, for example, that is the cold-blooded animal is the fish. Okay, generally these animals is the cold-blooded. Okay, another next is the homeothermic animals. Okay, in that, in some animals the body temperature remains constant and it is independent of environmental temperature. Okay, these animals are called homeothermic animals. What is mean by the homeothermic animals? The body temperature remains constant and it is independent of environmental temperature. Not dependent, it is independent of environmental temperature. These animals are called homeothermic animals. Okay. When the environment is the cold, the blood of these animals will be at higher temperature. Hence, these animals are called warm-blooded animals. Okay. If it is when the environment is cold, you know very well, at the time of winter season, the environment is too cold. That time our blood is also not cold. Our blood is also in the higher temperature, right? That we call it as, that animals is called as warm-blooded animals. Okay. They can regulate their body temperature by generating heat through metabolic activity. Hence, they are also called endothermic animals. Okay, for example, birds and mammals. Okay. And then next, biological effects of temperature. The biological effects of temperature is the heterothermic animals. Heterotherms behave like ectotherms and endotherms. Okay. Heterotherms behave like the ectotherms and endotherms. Means they generate heat, but they cannot regulate their body temperature within a narrow range like endotherms. Okay. With the flying insects, for example, okay, tunas, mackerels, mako, sharks, python, okay, these are the camels, these are the heterothermic animals. Okay, heterothermic animals. Another, next, the biological effect is the metabolism and reaction rate. Okay, we know very well temperature, it is the effects on various biochemical activities. Okay, metabolic as well as biochemical activities. Okay, and temperature are catalyzed by enzymes, and enzyme in turn are influenced by temperature. Hence, fluctuation of temperature bring about marked changes in metabolic activity. Okay, the rates of chemical reaction are increased as the temperature. Okay, that is called as the metabolic reaction. Okay. Another, next is the next effects of growth. Okay, effects on growth. Temperature affects the growth of animals. For example, the oyster grows to 1.4 mm when it is reared at 10 degrees Celsius. But when it is reared at 20 degrees Celsius, it grows to 10.3 mm. Okay, that is the effect of growth. Okay, and that is the effect of temperature on growth. Okay, another example, that the sea urchin is also grows to maximum size when the water is warm. Okay, that is the one particular examples of effects of temperature on growth. Okay, another, next is the development. Temperature influences the development of organism. Okay, we know very well the egg of mackerel fish does not develop below 8 degrees Celsius and above 25 degrees Celsius, but it starts to develop at a 10 degrees Celsius. It means the effect of temperature on development. Okay, another, that is the reproduction. Okay, another effect of temperature is the reproduction. Okay, the reproduction of animals is influenced by temperature. Okay, example, that is the in blow fly. Okay, egg laying starts at 22 degree Celsius and it increases with the rise of temperature up to 32.5 degree Celsius. Further, increase in temperature decrease the number of eggs. Okay, that is the one particular effect of temperature on reproduction. Okay, another sex ratio. When temperature is allowed to increase, the sex ratio is affected. Okay, in the copepod. Okay, copepod is the zooplankton. Okay, that males increase in number when the temperature rises. Okay, the one particular example of effect of temperature on sex ratio. Okay. Another, next is the coloration. Okay, the insect, birds and mammals living in a warm humid regions, you know very well, and they are dark in color due to the development of more pigments. Okay, it means that is the, we know very well at the time of summer season, if we going to the hot or scorching sun or in the daytime, that time our skin is very blackish. It is the effect of temperature on coloration. It means the dark in color due to the development of more pigments. Okay, another effect, the morphology and distribution. Okay, the morphological character of organism are altered by the temperature. The temperature influences the size of animals and relative proportion of the parts of the body. Okay, this phenomenon is called as Bergmann's rule. Okay, that rules is called as Bergmann's rule. Okay. Birds and mammals living in a colder regions attain maximum size. Okay, if you compare the birds and mammals. Okay, that generally they have living in the colder region, that it will be the maximum size. Okay, of animals and birds. Okay, and that is the effect of temperature on morphology. Another, next, the mutation and crossing over. Okay, that is the next biological effect, the mutation and crossing over. In that, high temperature influences mutation. Okay, if it is the high temperature occur, that time mutation is there. With the example, for example, Drosophila reared in a 27 degree Celsius develop mutation the two times more than those reared at only 17 degree Celsius. Okay, as compared to two times mutation is done. Okay, our mutation is occur. Sorry, mutation is occur. Another, next one is the behavior and regeneration. Okay, as the effect of temperature on behavior and regeneration. We know very well temperature influences the behavior patterns of animals. Right, example. When snakes know the arrival of cold climate, they coil up their body and huddle together. Okay, we know very well a snake, if it is going to the cold region, that time they have coil up the body. Okay, and huddle together. And that is another the effect of temperature on regeneration. When the temperature increases, the regeneration power is increased. Okay, in planaria the regeneration is impossible at 3 degree Celsius, but when the temperature is increased to 29.7 degree Celsius, the regeneration is most rapid. Okay, that is the effect of temperature on regeneration. Okay, and another, next is the weak skeleton and death. Okay, skeleton and death. Okay, another, it means that is the effect of temperature on weak skeleton also. Okay, in a deep sea animal, if you've seen, the skeleton is weak, fragile and uncalcified. You see in the deep sea animal, that skeleton is a very weak and fragile and uncalcified. This is because the deep sea animals are unable to synthesize calcium at low temperature, okay, in the deep sea. That is why they have the effect of temperature on weak skeleton. Another, the last one is the effect of temperature on death. Okay, when animals are exposed to extreme temperature, they die. Okay, we know very well, if we go into the 100 degrees Celsius at that time, we will still survive. Not okay, we will die because the animals are exposed to extreme temperature. That is why the effect of temperature on death. Okay, so this is it for today. So today we have seen that is the temperature abiotic factor, that there are various types of concepts we have clear today. Okay, in the next lecture, remaining part we'll see. Okay, so this is it for today.